Hello everybody, what's going on? Jerome here, and today I have you guys an awesome new Minecraft showcase by Minecraft PG5. This is basically a map where it's an automated animal farm. It actually ends up killing the animals for you and cooking them in the end and serving them straight on a nice little platter over here. It's really awesome, and I highly suggest you checking it out. Once again, it's all made by Minecraft PG5, and the link to it is down below. So congratulations, it is a great map. So what you do is you come over here, and you press the magical button there, and then, wait a minute, bam, water starts pushing all the animals from over there straight down here. And you're probably saying, Jerome, what's the point of this if you're just going to lose all your farm? Well, he was smart enough to add this second area over here, which is kind of like the breeding area, quote-unquote. And what that'll allow you to do is keep some of them alive so that you can run over here, make sure that they breed for the future and expand, and then finally you can kind of just, you know, redo the process all over again without losing all of your livestock. So they're going to end up falling down there, and then the way you can follow them, you don't have to come down here to follow them, but just optional. You can come here and watch them. Basically, this water wave right here will push them all into this hole down here, which will push them straight into the lava. And just so you guys can get a different little look on it, you run down here to the redstone room. They get killed, basically, they drop from the lava, they go down on the bottom floor, and they burn to death. It's a combination of fall damage as well as extended fire damage and a little bit of lava damage, so it's a threefer. These guys are, trust me, they're not going anywhere. These guys are pretty much as good as dead. And then finally, eventually, you're wondering, Jerome, why didn't I close or shut the machine off? The machine actually automatically shuts itself off once it feels like it's done. I'm not sure how it determines that, but you'll quickly notice that the water right there will slowly go away, and everything will be done on its own. So let's just see real quick. Go back up top here. And eventually, once again, this water will start to retract. As you can tell, it already closed itself off, which is step one. And then step two is going to be that it begin shutting that off, and then you can run back down here. Where is it? And what happens is, over here, the piston pushes the items along the ice, and now it's on to the final step. So there's only one more step after this, and that is it making its way, ascending up to make it outside. Here we go. You ready, guys? Push up one. It's going to keep going like that, and then dun 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 dun. You run over here and you wait for your hot platter of all cooked meats as well as leather from the cows. So it's really awesome, and I think I like it a lot. It allows you to work with pretty much any type of mob. You can do this with pigs, you can do this with cows. Obviously it doesn't cook, you know, other mobs' materials, say if you put like a blaze in there or something, which I don't even know if blaze take lava damage, that's a bad example. But say like a zombie spawner or something like that, I'm sure you could use this for it as well, and everything is fine. So as you can see, we got tons of cooked steaks, leather, and a little bit of cooked pork chop, not much, you know what I mean, there weren't as many pigs in there. But yeah, you guys get the point. So thank you all for watching, hope you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to subscribe and check out my other content. I do stuff like this all the time, and I love going after Minecraft showcases. And yeah, so thank you guys for watching. Once again, check me out and have a good night.